Good afternoon, 47. Your destination is Marrakesh, Morocco, where civil riots are looming. Your targets are private banker Klaus Strandberg and army general Reza Zedan, two of the conspirators in a sinister plot to overthrow Morocco's fragile government. Strandberg, a former bank CEO who stole billions of dollars worth of savings from the Moroccan people, was facing trial for investment fraud. But early this morning, a band of heavily armed mercenaries freed Strandberg from his prison transport, resulting in the death of several police officers. Strandberg now takes refuge at his native Swedish consulate, in front of which crowds of angry protesters have gathered, demanding his handover to Moroccan authorities. We believe General Zedan orchestrated Strandberg's escape to infuriate the public and spark nationwide riots, allowing Zedan to impose martial law. Operating out of a field HQ at a nearby abandoned school, he will no doubt use the riots to depict the Rabat government as weak and inept, and persuade the general staff to support a fully-fledged military coup in the name of national security. Our client, building contractor Hamilton Lowe, who stands to lose a fortune in government contracts, has hired us to prevent the coup d'etat. To do so, you need to paralyze Zedan's rebel forces and prevent the riots from escalating further, hence the double contract. This is quite the political powder keg, 47, so be careful. The fate of a nation is at stake. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Marrakesh, 47. The situation grows more tense by the minute. The consulate is under lockdown, but the protests are only a stone throw away from full-blown riots, and Zedan won't hesitate to unleash his troops. So whatever you're planning, time is of the essence. Good luck, 47.
Thanks for asking. He's upstairs right now working on this novel of his, some kind of political thriller, I think. You know, airport lit.
Oh, that's nice. So he doesn't miss the old school?
Well, he was headmaster for 30 years, and he still carries around the master key. You know, the one that fits all the locks? He doesn't seem to be able to part with the damn thing. But that's nostalgia for you.
Well, maybe now he'll be a famous writer instead.
Right. And maybe my carpets are magical.
Give your old man some credit, Marwin. He might surprise you yet. Anyway, gotta run. See you around.
Yep, up, up and away.
Good. Now, let's see. The Omega Charter series, book one, title Diplomacy's Edge. When his best friend is killed by a Langley approved drone strike in the mountains of Pakistan, CIA analyst Nick Sparta quits the agency in protest. 3 years later, Nick works as a freelance security advisor in Egypt. However, when a dying Interpol agent hands him a badly damaged USB key containing fragments of the mysterious Omega Charter, Nick Sparta is forced back into the deadly world of espionage. A sinister cabal of powerful individuals are orchestrating a coup d'etat that could potentially destabilize the entire region, and Nick is the only one with the knowledge and skills to thwart them. Not bad. Not bad at all. Now, how do I use that ass Strandberg in all this? Perhaps Omega are using the Strandberg character as a lightning rod. They allow him to escape and take shelter at the embassy in Cairo, expecting riots to break out. That is perfect. I should probably make him Norwegian or Danish. No, wait. Finnish, that's suitably exotic. Cynical banker Jaakko Arola. Yeah, yes, I like the sound of that. Now, so far so good. So, where does all this lead? Oh.
General Zaden keeps coming down here to check on the prisoner. I hear they were close, so what'd he do, poor bastard?
Way I heard it, his brother was one of the policemen who got killed when the mercs attacked Strandberg's prison transport this morning. So he got cold feet, tried to blow the lid on the whole operation.
Not smart.
But pretty human. I'm just glad I wasn't picked for the firing squad.
I hear you.
Work 47. Now to locate General Zaden.
Chest hair, right? Come on. Everyone knows Zaden is just an upper-class fop. His dad was Secretary of State, and his family's practically royalty. The only way this guy was not going to become general was if he took a dump on the flag.
You're not wrong, that's for sure.
You're dismissed. General Zaden's order.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Raquel. She'll kill him. She'll find out that he's been cheating on her and stab him in his sleep. And I'll be there watching. Front row seats. Yeah. Is someone in here? Hello?
That is General Reza Zaidan, Keeper of the Peace.
Time to decide. What should I do? Don't tell me you're sleeping, Zaid. Plenty of time for that, I'm sure. So what'll be, old friend? Firing squad? Poison? Hanging? So many choices.
Target down. Move on to Klaus Strandberg.
Salutations, sir.
Thank you. I salute you, sir.
Sorry. Hello, sir. Oh, do you have pardon me? I didn't see you there, sir. All right. Go on through. Welcome, sir.
How are you, sir?
Hey, wait a
minute. Please, kiss and make up for me, for my birthday. Press is here.
I just got the fastest car in the whole world.
Huh.
psychophant from affluent Scandinavia has pilfered from the citizens of Morocco. And what is our government doing to protect us from the white-collar predators like Claus Strandberg? I'll tell you what they're doing. They're doing what they do best. Nothing. That's what. No, my friends, our government is much too busy paying lip service to Western financial institutions to care about justice for the Moroccan people. Me, tell me, is this what you want? Huh? U.S.-flavored cutthroat capitalism? A system where shit floats to the top. Is it, my friends? Well, I say no. It is time for a third way. Real socio-economic progress that rejects the failed political dogmas of the 20th century. If there is a silver lining here, it is this. The Claus Strandbergs of the world are teaching us a valuable lesson. They teach us to say no to greed and to build a fairer, more egalitarian monetary system. Thank you.
Members of the Free Press are always welcome.
Thanks for responding so quickly. We never expected something like this. We're not Denmark.
Don't mention it. Nobody wants a diplomatic crisis on their hands. Of course, if this thing
were a gate, cameraman, how are you?
We don't have the muscle to secure the gate either. And it's all up to the military.
And what about Crystal Dawn? Any movement?
Apart from the flyers, nothing. Never operated on Moroccan territory before.
My guess.
Okay, remember, technically, Stromberg has not been convicted of any crime. So, we're not allowed to ask directly about the location of the 7 billion. Stick to the facts.
I got it.
The accusations, the trial, Stromberg's dramatic breakout. You know, get his side of the story.
Title. I got this.
Right. And you, aim and shoot. This is it, guys. Big one.
You made it. Most impressive, 47. Now to locate
hey there,
Klaus Strandberg.
Oh, Pam Kingsley? GNN News? My name is Pearson. Mr. Strandberg is ready for you. Follow me, please. I must say I was surprised that Consul Olander authorized this interview. Adding fuel to the fire, I should think. But that is not my call. Nevertheless, you must understand that the building is on high alert. If the situation evolves, you will be evacuated without protest. Yes?
Well, let's just hope it doesn't come to that, Ms. Pearson.
Don't mind me.
Aha. Capital, you made it. Come on in. Come in, good. Pam Kingsley, a pleasure. I watch your show all the time. You're even more lovely in the flesh. And this is...
Tyler Clark, producer. And this is our cameraman, Finley.
Tyler and Finley. Splendid. Well, let's do this, shall we? Where do you want me? The light is nice over here. Not that I want to tell you boys how to do your jobs, good heavens.
Well, right here is fine, Mr. Strandberg. Sit down, make yourself comfortable, and we'll be ready in no time.
Oh, no, no, please, please. Call me Klaus.
Okay, I think we're set. Roll when you're ready.
Camera rolling.
Hey, when you got a sec, think you could do something about the lights? Upstairs somewhere? Thanks, bud.
Okay, we're ready if you are, Mr. Sanders.
Access to the consulate and first row seats for the interview. Nicely done, 47.
Just need to frisk you, sir. This'll go a lot easier if you'll just show me what you're hiding. Off you go, sir.
Say what?
Gee, thanks.
These must have misunderstood their own legislation.
Misunderstood? How do you mean?
None of those transactions were illegal. Everything was done in strict accordance with Moroccan law. Now, you might call it a loophole. You might call it creative bookkeeping. But the law is the law, Miss Kingsley, and I am a firm believer in the law.
Let me get this straight, Mr. Stramberg. You are openly admitting to taking this money, the $7 billion, from the Moroccan people?
Why not? An opportunity presented itself, and I seized it. Again, all within the confines of the law. So, what should I apologize for? Being a capitalist? Perhaps the term has fallen out of favor with your middle-class viewers, Miss Kingsley, but me? I bear that brand proudly. Capital C.
If you are innocent in the eyes of the law, why did violent assailants spring you from police custody this morning, claiming the lives of 6 police officers?
Well, that I'm afraid I cannot answer. Some philanthropist, sympathetic to my ordeal, no doubt. I appreciate the gesture, but the approach was somewhat excessive, really quite unnecessary. I would have walked free eventually, once justice had run its due course.
Mr. Stramberg, hundreds are gathered outside this very building, howling for your blood. Is there anything you wish to say to them?
Two little words. Fuck you.
Pam, we need to call it a wrap. I think the damn hard drive overheated.
Miss Kingsley.
Oh.
Put those targets down. Now head towards an exit.
What do you make of him, Stramberg?
I don't know.
You know who the person is? I need to know, please!
Hey, babe, it's me.
Hey. And again.
Oh, the prince is here!
Isn't it? You know, sociopaths. That's how they get you to trust them.
Hey, camera guy.
I'm just disconnecting because I'm calling you. I shouldn't even be able to have this conversation right now. My service should have been disconnected. Yes, I'm still getting bills. No, I'm not paying because I disconnected my service. Just look at the number and disconnect it. Thank you.
compromised. But I don't understand. There is no sign of forced entry, no alarms, nothing.
One of my people has gone missing in Johannesburg. A key bearer.
I wish I'd been informed. Still, the system demands two keys, and the rest are all accounted for.
Except for your late predecessors.
Cobb? But his plane went down over the Pacific. It was an accident.
Such was the conclusion at the time. Yes. People die, Mr. Fannin. Happens all the time, even to us. It seems like a conspiracy. Probably isn't. And yet, the failed coup in Morocco, the ether virus. Someone knows about us. There was a pattern and I failed to see it. Providence is under attack.
How much was there?
Money? Not money, Mr. Fannin. Information on all of our assets and operatives, like you. Dig a trench, Director, and make it a deep one, because none of you are safe anymore.